Hey, pop pickers! Welcome to the video where we answer the question that's on all your minds. Thank you very much, The Who, for that fantastic question, but that is not a question we will be answering today. The question, of course, is Lego Vidiyo, smash hit, or top of the flops? Alright folks, so welcome to this video. Excuse the cheesy openings, but I couldn't resist. The question being, of course, Lego Vidiyo, smash hit, or top of the flops? Or maybe it's just a one-hit wonder. Get a bit of enjoyment out of it to start with, but that'll be a lot. So, today what we're going to do is we're going to have a look at the Lego Vidiyo products we've got here. We've got one of the beatboxes and one bandmate. Now, the reason we've only got one of each is because actually this took a bit of time to get hold of. These didn't appear in the shops really that quickly due to the pandemic that's going on, lockdowns and global shipping issues. So I was lucky enough to get one of these at £12, RRP 18, so I got that cheapish. And I got this actually for £2.50. In B&M, not the video you may have seen that I posted recently of a shopping trip. On a previous shopping trip, I picked up one of these at £2.50 because they were the first time they were in there on offer. So I got that cheap. So I thought it was a good opportunity to take a look at the product we've got here and just give it a go. I mean, I am not the target demographic for this product. I am a 40 something middle-aged guy who likes to play with a bit of Lego, collect a bit of Lego, and I like the minifigs. But I'm all for giving a little go at some of these apps and things. So what I'm going to do is we're going to get into this because I've not even looked at an unboxing or anything to see what's in the box. Okay, do come join me on the other side of the camera and we'll see what's in there.
Okay, so I've changed my mind. I decided not to bring you around my side. I'll just bring you a bit closer up. So we'll put the little one to one side for now and we will open this one up. What we've got here is the Llama Beat Box. So there are six different ones of these. The box just shows artwork for the specific one you've got. If I give you a quick munch round, that shows you a bit about the app and how it works. That's a general cover to show you which one you've got. That one shows you a bit more what's in the box. And then we're back to that. And then we've got that on the top of the box. So let's get into it. Just to read a few of the bits off the box, it says Party Llama Beatbox. Choose music from the library. Scan your bandmate and beat bits. Record your own music videos. Beat bits will vary. Ah, so that's interesting. Interesting to find out. Okay, so let's get into this. Thankfully, it's not a punch tab, so we can just get the knife in across the nice bit here. Let's get into it and have a look. Okay. So, as you open it, that's what's in the box. So we've got this piece. You can see, looking at this, there's lots of new molds and things. So that's possibly why the cost is so much. We've got the instruction manual, another bit of the beat box, plate, a random piece. Again, these are all looking like new molds, so that's probably why the cost of the thing is a bit more than we would maybe like. It's a strap thing. And then of course we get into the bags. We've got two bags and a separator. One of those rare orange ones. So that's all your bits and bobs that are in there. And I can see that the beat bits, there's some beat bits in that one. Oh, I'm trying to get it without any light reflection and getting it to focus. Come on, focus, focus. No, it doesn't want to focus. But some of the beat bits are in that bag anyway. And then some of the beat bits are in that bag. And that appears to be the majority of the bits of my Llama. So that's the bits. And this is the little instruction book. Have a quick flip. Oh, so that opens up. You can't see that. I can't quite get far enough out. It's basically about a double A4 sort of size, A3 sort of size. And that is the instructions on how to build up your meat box. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to build this up, stick it on time lapse, and I'll talk to you once I've got it done. So there you have it. That is your built, I'll bring him in closer as you're flipping a little bit, built beatbox. And in there you've got your llama figure. So obviously for play, you can just crack that bit off. That's quite handy for carrying around and carry a little thing around. All right, okay, so we'll take that off. So you've got your llama in there, and now this is your beatbox bit. Now on the instruction it does show that on these you stick your beat bits. Okay, so these are our 16 beat bits that come with the beatbox, and I've separated them. You can see there are two over here that are exclusive to that particular minifig. Now each of the beatboxes comes with 16 altogether, two of which are specific to the figure in the box. The other 14 are a random assortment that are, well, as it sounds, randomized across all the different products that are available in the Vidiyo line. So let's have a quick look. So obviously we've got a pair of maracas, which our party llama is sporting as accessories. We've got this one, which is kind of jungly. I don't quite know what that's about. So they're the ones that are specific to him. So I'm assuming that in the game, the AR simulation part with the making the dance videos, you can only use those two with this character. So what else have we got? Kind of got a flowery, powery, kind of almost 70s vibe on that one. That looks a little bit explosive. A man with a sax. That could be fun. That sort of looks almost Japanese, sort of karaoke bar-esque. There's something else sort of disco-y about that. Don't know what that one's all about. That was kind of funky lighting. That one, maybe some sort of rock out, maybe rock out theme. That was kind of ballet-like. We've got some sort of flying cat. Don't know what that one's all about. We've got some pandas and a screaming chicken. Dancing girly in the stars. I'm wondering if that maybe put some sort of star sparkly filter over your video. And that one looks a little bit sort of gothic. So possibly some sort of gothic effect. So that is the 16 beat bits that you get. At least we got with this specific one. So there's some interesting looking beat bits there. I quite like the idea of the sax, because that could do something fun. And the flying cat, who knows? We'll see what that does when we give it a try. So here is our party llama. I hadn't realised that he's actually wearing roller skates. I knew he had his pair of maracas, but I had no idea he was on skates. He's got a very 70s sort of 70s disco, roller disco, 70s roller disco vibe about him. But that is how he stands on his, well, stand on his beatbox. I'm just going to look at the printing. I mean, there's some really sort of detailed printing. He's got his whistle as well for his rave, for his disco. It's just really cool, and those glasses. That is a whole molded piece, that head. Those glasses are not a separate item. And coming round, I hadn't noticed. I don't know if I can get this focus. The tattoo on his arm and the markings on the side as well. It's a really well-printed figure. Spinning around this way for you to have a look on this side. Oh, come back into focus, your drama llama. Nothing on this side. And I'll just pick him up to have a look and see if there's anything on his back. So yeah, it's just got more of the printing similar to the front on the back. So that is that figure. Now, I rather like that. That's good. The figure's good. And I can see these even without using the app and the AR technology. And I see these being as fun collectibles, because I'm a bit of a collector myself. I've got a lot of the CMFs. I collected things as a child, sort of collecting cards. But these beat bits, I quite like the idea of collecting these. And I believe there's 100 and... I want to say 104. I could be wrong at that number. It's over 100, but not by much. So I quite like to try and collect them all. So obviously there, we've got 16 unique ones in here, two of which were specific to the character. Now, talking of that, if we come to our bandmate, in these you get one figure and three beat bits, as you can see. Now, in them, one beat bit is unique to the character and the other two are random. So, in theory, in this box, there could be whatever random figures in here, the specific beat bit that goes with it, and then two of these beat bits that we've already got. There might already be some duplicates. But there's only one way to find out. Let's get into it. So there we have it. Anyway, that is the sort of disco-looking bunny-like thing. And I like the fact she actually has a beatbox, because she doesn't come in a beatbox, she comes with a beatbox. Loving that. So we have got, I think that middle one is her unique tile, because of the colours in her top, kind of linking into the colours in the tile. Obviously, we know that one's not, because that one was one that we had in the Llama beatbox set. And that's another unique one. So far, the only disappointment is that I haven't got any pipes and drums, because some of them have got drums on, and there's also one with a set of bagpipes on. So that is actually a beat bit that I'm going to be looking out for. But until we get that, we'll keep looking. So that is that one. Again, I'm going to pop it down so that we can have a look at the printing on this torso. So looking closer, I mean, that's really, I mean, it's like she's got a leotard underneath. Looking at the shoulder strap there, and it's got kind of a sparkly, lightning, sort of strikey top on there. Again, it's got a 70s, 80s kind of disco vibe. Is that actually sparkly legs? I'm trying to work out if that is actually sparkly legs. I think it is, and we'll turn around. Have we got any printing on the back? Yeah, we've got, again, we can see there's kind of a leotard or a vest top of some sort on underneath her top she's got on. And there's the boom box, the beat box. So again, nice bit of printing on that. And it's interesting with the bright pink hair. And the beat bits, if we can get in close and get it to focus. Don't quite know what the middle one's going to do, assuming that, that is the one for her. Then, I mean, that could be the one for her as well, because that's kind of somebody potentially beatboxing. I don't know. I will have to look it up. And then we have got that one that we've already got. So, coming out, that's what we've got.
Okay, so there we have it. That is our beatbox. That is our beer bandmate. And I've given you my rough opinion of what I think of these figures as a collector in my 40s who rather likes collecting daft things like this. But I am not target demographic. I am not a child of, say, 8, 9, 10, 11 years old. I don't go around making music videos. I'm not on TikTok. I don't do that kind of thing. It doesn't really interest me. But that's the kind of person that this is generally aimed at if you want to do the interactive stuff with it. So I thought it might be a good idea to talk to somebody who is part of the target demographic. And it just so happens that our niece turned 10 years old about a month ago. And as a birthday present, may have received something similar to what we have sat in front of us.
Sweet DJ, could you give her this?
By any chance, is the wrapping paper and clue to what it is?
Maybe. Okay, so in there you've got an extra minifigure to use. That's what they call a bandmate. These ones are called beatboxers, and they're like a bigger box with a build and what have you, with the minifigure and a load of mini beat bits. And then your little box is an extra character with a few more beat bits. And then the beat bits, I think, yeah, the beat bits, I think, give you different special effects to use in your videos. I think. I've not had a go with it yet. If I let you have that and have a play with it for a few weeks, will you help me do a video?
Yes!
Yes?
Yes!
Is that all right with Mummy?
Yes.
Cool. Right, so in a couple of weeks, once you've had plenty of time to play with that, we'll do a review and we'll tell our viewers what we think of it.
Yeah.
Cool.
So as you can see, DJ's Lego cousin was over the moon to be asked to be in this video and with her Lego that she received. Now, it's actually been nearly a month since she received those Lego sets. So she's had plenty of time to have a play with them. So now, as if by magic, special effects are amazing, yeah? So we have DJ's Lego cousin here and she has been trying out the app with what she got. But before we talk about that, what have you got?
So I got the ice cream mermaid.
Yeah, she is quite cool.
Yeah, but the guitar is always in her face.
Guitar is in your face!
And her hair just fell off.
The dangers of being a Lego minifigure around a hyperactive 10-year-old. And what was your bandmate that you got?
The bandmate...
It looks familiar.
...was the same as...
It was the same. We have two. They do come with different beat bits, though, apart from the central one, which is the rainbow stripe unique one to this figure. And then that one has the trendy dance and the keytar. Keytar. That's a cool word. Keytar. Yeah.
And if you look closely at...
It's a little bit like your guitar, but it's a keytar. Because do you know why? Because it's got keys. It's a keytar. I can see that this video is going on forever. But there we go. Dad jokes aside, we'll put the mermaid back where she belongs. But yeah, let's have a quick look at your beat bits. Let's have a look at what you got. What I'm going to do is bring you in for a close look at some of these other beat bits that I didn't get.
Okay, so these are the beat bits that came with the... Ice cream mermaid, there she is. So these are the beat bits. So these two are unique to her. The icy, whoa, it's gone out of focus. The ice cream one and what appears to be like a horn.
It was only the ice cream on the website.
It was only ice cream on the website, but looking at other sources, it appears that the horn is the second unique one in this set. Looking across at the other beat bits, some of them are familiar. We have the flying cat again and the kind of hippie trippy 70s, sort of that one. Again, we've got another one of the trendy dancer. I can't remember if that's the same ballerina or a different one from what I got. Then we've got the gothic one again. We've got kind of looks a bit like Marilyn Monroe there with pink hair and a singing mouse. The rainbow one looks quite cool. You think it's a koala? Well, then we have the rainbow one and we have Godzilla by the look of it. Some sort of welding thing. I don't know what that'll do. Maybe do something with some sparks. We've got some steel drums. I think that one is a belching one. Don't know what that one is. And some more awesome rock out drums. So a couple of repetitions, a couple of new ones, but it's going to be interesting to see what these all do. Now we've had a look at what beat bits came with the ice cream mermaid, and we also know what came with this second bunny. I think it's about time we tried out the app. Right, let's head outside. Where there's nobody about, because the app says to be very careful to make sure nobody is in your shot that would not want to be without their permission. Let's go do it and film some videos. Okay, so the app's starting up. Somebody can't wait to dance. So let's go. Right, okay, so start with, you've got to confirm your age. So you were born in 1932, yeah. So you're an old person, 2011. That makes me feel very old. Okay, so when you load up, first off, you've got a choice of start playing with a free digital bandmate or using your figures, such as this one, that you have purchased. Now, this is actually something I see as a weakness. I mean, I appreciate that not everyone wants to go out and buy the actual Lego product, but come on, Lego, you're trying to sell a product here. You know, you want people to go out and buy your product, so I don't like the fact. I don't know if I'd like it or not. I'm a bit torn with it. Anyway, we've got figures, so let's scan a bandmate. Beatbox. And then you find your character, and she's at the end.
Candy Mermaid is what she's actually called.
Candy Mermaid, oh, we've been calling her the wrong name all along. So yeah, while it's loading, you get these screens. Okay, so now what you need to do is line up your bandmate, like so, and get it scanned. That actually seemed quite easy, which is good. Okay. Okay, so raise and roll. And we click. So it's found. Right, so it's found five on that side. For some reason, it hasn't recognised one of the beep bits, but we'll go with it. We'll try it and we'll see what happens.
But we've just realised that these two here are actually from the llama.
So we will see.
And they're still picking up.
What it does with those. So let's do this. Right, you ready to dance?
Yeah!
Ready to roll. If you find a name.
Your band a name.
I quite like the zesty jams. Sketch the rose. The coffees. Yeah, that's what I need. The coffees. I need coffees.
I guess we're going with the coffees then.
Let's make a music video. Right, find a spot that's not too far away or too close. Okay, so what you need to do now then is get this and set it up. You can kind of see so that I'm not blocking. There, that looks good. Is she happy there? Do we think? Oh, back a bit, love. There you go. There we go. Right. We'll go with that. So there you have it, that's basically what you do, and then what you can do is you can go back and watch it. So once you've recorded your video, let's see what else you can do with it. So you can now edit your band. I think you can add it bad band members to it, the whole gallery. So you can scan an extra bandmate. So let's add an extra bandmate. Okay, so we've just added another bandmate to this. Let's see what it does now. It's doing everything on a side now. This is a little bit frustrating.
Well, the simple answer is...
Boom! Turn it that way up like that. Add to band. The coffees. Bit of boom. There we go, the coffees. Done.
Woohoo!
Right, let's play with them. Hello. Let me see my reflection. What are we going to play?
Believe it. There we go.
Okay.
Okay, so it looked like outside you were having a lot of fun. I've got to say, you were killing it. Whoa, I like totally went back to like playing Grand Theft Auto Vice City there, man. That was like totally trippy. What happened? That was weird. Anyway, on with the show. Looking at Lego Vidiyo, what do you think? Do you like it?
Amazing! I'm definitely going to have to make a music video and put it onto my YouTube channel.
Blatant plug there. I'll put the link down the bottom. So, there we go. That is the verdict of target demographic. Is it, let's get it in the words of the question, smash hit or top of the flops?
Smash it!
She smashed it. I think it was a very... I had a lot of fun actually working out there on the iPad, doing the videoing and pressing all the buttons and seeing what all the different beat bits did. Because Yeah, there was some crazy stuff going on there. I mean, we tried out, one thing we did try out was we did try out the beat bits from this character with this character. So the unique ones.
If your question was that do unique bits that come from different sets work with your set, the answer is yeah!
Yeah, baby. Yeah, baby, it does. I don't know what she's bringing out of me. I'm turning into some sort of young person. But anyway, it was a lot of fun. So you think it's a smash hit. The question is, if you could have more, would you have more?
Yes!
So right, can you help me make this happen? Because I haven't told her about this. Can you, the viewers, make this happen? If we can get this video up to 100 views, 100 more views is all I ask. It's not that many. 100 views, I personally will buy some more Lego video for this young lady here. And I think that will make her very happy looking at that. So share it with your friends. Just watch it over and over again. You can share it with your friends.
Yeah, I know. One of my friends were asking, what are you doing today? And I was like, I'm doing a YouTube video with my uncle.
Yeah, that's cool. Glad you think so. But yes, that's it. Come on. Help me out, people. This girl needs more Lego. She needs more Lego video in her life. She needs more special effects. Help her out. Get this video up to 100 views. But as well as views, what else can you do? You can like the video. Hit that like button.
Subscribe!
We're getting on musical. It's a musical video. You can subscribe and you can hit that bell. Ding, 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 ding. You can get notifications when we upload more content. And if you want to see her in another video, that's another thing I forgot to say. If you would like to see her in another one of my videos, I want 50 likes on this video. 50 whole likes. If we can get 50 likes, she'll come back and do another video with me. Well, I hope she will.
There's every chance I will.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah, because today I finished building a huge Lego Yoda that you can also get in the Lego store.
Lego Yoda? Oh, yeah, Lego Child.
Lego Child.
Lego Child. That's something I've not built. See, I've not got any Star Wars stuff.
It took me like 2 weeks.
It took you 2 weeks. Well, what you could do is you could do a Lego showcase on that build on your YouTube channel. You just take your camera or whatever, do a video of it, get it on your YouTube, and I'll send the people over to come and view it. How's that sound? Yeah?
Yeah.
You'll go and look at it, won't you? Yeah, I know you will, because you're my quality viewers. Right, and that, anyway, that's enough. We've said, smash it! Not top of the flops. Are you ready for the end bit? We DJ knows this bit off by heart. Are you any good at it? You haven't got a clue, have you? She doesn't even watch my videos. What good is this?
Well, I did watch the Advent ones, but only for a tiny bit because I had to do schoolwork.
That's right, kids. Do your schoolwork. But there's no kids watching this. You're all over 13 or plus because otherwise I get in trouble. Anyway, as I will teach her now, the way we finish videos in this household is thanks for being a part of our brick life. Till next time. Bye-bye.
Bye. My hand's getting sore.
I'm so cold. I need to go and put a hoodie on and then we can go make some videos. Well, then if I'm jumping around, we might not need to. Right, just go and do some videos using the llama because I want to dance with the llama.